Good morning, this is Dr. Bhupesh from Dr. BKM Institute. So we are recording another letter, just of course for the OIT purpose. And the second thing is that we have got a very special letter today. It's something that belongs to writing to parents or grandparents. How do we get to know that whether it is for the parents or grandparents? That is, of course, a thing to be noted, because in exams, sometimes it would be given, but most of the times, of course, it would be well mentioned that whether it is for parents or grandparents. So how do we get to know about these things? Again, it is very important to read it closely. And again, please listen to the recording 2-3 times. Whenever you do that, again, repeating the same thing. First time is to listen, second time is to understand, and third time is to execute. So when you listen to the recording 3 times, you are able to execute that learning by yourself, which you have learned from us. So please listen to the recording 3 times. Okay, coming back to the point, first of all, to whom we are writing the letter. सबसे important OET में हमेशा यही रहेगा कि हम letter किसको लिख रहे हैं. So to whom we are writing the letter is the first thing that we need to consider. That will always be the most important point. So write a letter advice to Mr. and Mrs. Johnson, Hall Oak, this Melbourne, 3008 Victoria, following discharge of their son. So this is a very different letter from OET. And the chances are very less. To be honest, I have been teaching more than 7 years. The letter of such kind has not appeared in the exams until now. So can't really say this will come, but at least we want you to practice and go through these kind of letters. If by chance this is the only thing that pops up, then you would be realizing, of course, then you would be appreciating that we have joined the best institute and they have prepared us for everything. So that is what we want to be. We want to prepare you for everything, whatever is possible. So this letter is a very different one. And this particularly says that we have to write to the parents for the son. So again, there are 2-3 rules that we have discussed. When we are writing under 18 years of age, when there is anybody, so we say master in the case of males and miss in the case of females. And always use the first name. Normally in OET, we use the second name. Normally, whenever we are executing OET task, we use the second name of the patient that your mentors would have told you. And if not, I'm telling you that if normally in the OET, we use the second name of the patient. Means, suppose if patient name is John Brown, so I will use Mr. Brown, Mr. Brown. So that is how used in OET. But in case of anybody who is less than 18 years old, that means less than 18 years is master for the males. And for the females, it is Miss. So we use the first name. Suppose name is Julie and Julie niece, and you will write Miss niece, Miss Julie. So you will not write the second name, you will use the first name. So that is what is the difference between the two. So now we are supposed to write the letter for the son, Sammy. So if we go through the name of son on the first page, then we will realize Sammy Johnson. So we will write, and the date of birth is 6, and it's the time now is 15. That means he is around 9 years old. So we will say Master Sammy. I'm writing this letter regarding Master Sammy. Or yahan pe in this particular letter, you will say, I'm writing this letter regarding your son, Master Sammy. So who was admitted to our hospital due to falling on an outstretched arm, pain, tenderness, bruising, and swelling. So ye parents ko pata hi hoga. Of course, parents would be aware. So you don't have to write everything. So I'm writing this letter regarding your son who was admitted to our hospital due to falling on an outstretched arm and was diagnosed with distal radius fracture. So do not now suppose. Again, that is why, again, I'm teaching you the most important thing again and again, what OET is all about. Suppose parents are sitting right in front of you and you are telling the parents that your son, you know, he had pain, tenderness. Parents will not be liking it to listen to it again. Do you realize, like, aapka beta agar aapke, sorry, aise nahi kehna chahiye, but aapke matlab agar koi known mein unka bete ke bare mein koi bata raha aur dobara se bata hai aapka beta gir gaya tha, aapko pain hua tha, aapko pata to hai aisa hua tha. So in these kind of letters, always imagine hum letter kisko likh rahe hain. To jab hum parents ko letter likh rahe hain, to unko bas itna batana hai ki aapka son hamare paas admit hua tha girne ke karan aur diagnosed hua tha distal fracture se, ab wo theek hai. So itni si baat likhni hai, lekin aapko ghar pe kuch instructions ko follow karna hai for his speedy recovery. So this letter is a very different letter. So is letter mein koi hospitalization jo normal pattern hum follow karte hain, koi hospitalization, कोई कुछ नहीं होता इसमें, सीधा यही होता है कि हाँ आपका बेटा इसमें सारे के सारे पॉइंट्स वो बनेंगे, द ऑल द पॉइंट्स वुड बी ऑफ द डिस्चार्ज प्लान. सो आई विल चेक इट फ्रॉम हेयर. सो इफ आई से आई एम राइटिंग दिस लेटर रिगार्डिंग योर सन मास्टर सैमी, हु वॉज एडमिटेड टू अवर हॉस्पिटल ड्यू टू फॉलिंग ऑन एन आउटस्ट्रेच्ड आर्म एंड वॉज डायग्नोज विद डिस्टल फ्रैक्चर. आफ्टर द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द प्लास्टर कास्ट अलॉन्ग विद द मेडिकेशन हिज कंडीशन हैज इम्प्रूव्ड, सो ही इज बींग डिस्चार्ज. दैट इज द फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ. सो ही इज बींग डिस्चार्ज, फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ इज ऑलवेज अबाउट द पर्पज. सो पर्पज, सो ही इज बींग डिस्चार्ज बिकॉज ही इज बेटर, सो ही इज बींग डिस्चार्ज. बट एट होम, सो यू बेटर देन बट इज हाउएवर, हाउएवर एट होम, सो यू राइट दिस, यू नीड टू फॉलो फ्यू इंस्ट्रक्शंस, फॉलो फ्यू इंस्ट्रक्शंस फॉर हिज स्पीडी रिकवरी. सो दैट इज हाउ यू राइट द फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ ऑफ लेटर्स लाइक दिस. अगेन यू डोंट हैव टू क्रैम एनीथिंग, यू डोंट हैव टू मग अप एनीथिंग. फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ इज ऑलवेज अबाउट पर्पज. What is the purpose of the letter? So you can well imagine that I am telling the parents that I am writing this letter regarding your son who was admitted to our hospital due to falling on an outstretched arm and was diagnosed with distal radius fracture. Now after treatment, if you want to say Siddha, if you don't want to say past plaster cast was applied, so you can simply say now after treatment his condition has improved, so he is being discharged. However, at home you need to follow a few instructions for his speedy recovery. Then the letter will become very simple. This kind of letter will go simply. That you know during hospitalized it would be sorry you are requested to follow few you are advised to follow few instructions. You can also say you are advised to follow few instructions. Then you start mentioning about the instruction that you can say Master Sammy. So the next paragraph you will start, the second paragraph you will start Master Sammy can be sore. So Master Sammy sore मतलब पेन, may be sore for several days. So if he is in pain, please give him pain killers. ये वर्ड रहने दो. Also, it is important to be noted not to overdose him. So you can make this line. So you can paraphrase the statement simple. The second line, it is important not to overdose him. You can start up this thing as this, not to overdose him. Nor he will become and nor he should become. So it is very important. Don't mention will. So you say not to overdo him is and nor he should become. ना ही वो बनना चाहिए. तो आपको ये ध्यान रखना है. He should not become addicted. So that is where OET. That is what OET is all about. Using the same information, putting it in your own language, whatever suits nicely over there. So we want to say it. He should not become addicted to the medications. You may give painkillers regularly for first 3 days as needed. So this would be the first paragraph. So in the first paragraph, we have talked about the pain. Second paragraph, we will talk about that Master Sammy can go back to school, or you can say otherwise you can say Master Sammy is all good. Master Sammy can go back to school as soon he feels well enough, and also X-ray would be conducted after 3 weeks. Physical therapy should be commenced. To help him improve the motion and function of the injured wrist, cast ये cast वाली बात we will write it in a separate paragraph otherwise. So or you will mention also it is important to be noted that cast must be kept dry or a plastic bag over the arm and a plastic bag over the arm while showering should be used. If the cast does become wet, what is cast? जैसे हम plaster चढ़ाते हैं तो plaster की बात कर रहा है कि plaster जो चढ़ाया है उसको dry रखना है, plastic bag को चढ़ा के ही आपको नहाना है. So plastic bag should be kept over the arm. So that is how you make the passive voice. That is what OET needs from you. That is the only thing it needs from you, your grammar. So it's a passive voice, should be kept. It's a passive voice. So should be kept, a plastic bag should be kept over the arm while showering. And if the cast becomes wet, so you can remove this does. If the cast becomes wet, अगर वो गीली हो जाती है, it will not dry very easily. So you can use the connectors. So it will not dry easily. So या फिर देयरफॉर, या फिर आप ऐसे लिखते हो फॉर विच, जिसके लिए, फॉर विच अ हेयर ड्रायर कैन बी यूज्ड, अ हेयर ड्रायर ऑन द कूल सेटिंग मे बी हेल्पफुल. सो यू कैन यूज द सेम लाइन. सो दिस इज हाउ यू कनेक्ट द लाइन. सो इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट टू बी नोटेड दैट कास्ट मस्ट बी केप्ट ड्राई एंड अ प्लास्टिक बैग शुड बी यूज्ड व्हाइल शावरिंग. इन केस इफ द कास्ट बिकम्स वेट, it will not dry very easily. Therefore, yeah, for which a hair dryer on the cool setting may be helpful. So you can use this thing. So again, listen to the recording 3 times. Otherwise, you will not be able to understand it very well. So further, it is important to be noted that Master Sammy can resume his activities such as swimming or exercises lower bend within 1 or 2 months after the cast is removed. Vigorous activities such as this may be joined after 3 to 6 months. Cast needs to be removed after 6 weeks. So this is where you need to understand OAT. So pick this line and make it the first line. Further, it is important to be noted that cast needs to be removed after 6 weeks. 6 weeks matlab lagbhag 1.5 mahina baad, lagbhag or approximately 1.5 months, 6 weeks. So that is how you will collect. Cast needs to be removed after 6 weeks, and after that child can resume light activities. So then you don't have to write this line after the cast is removed. So that is how you make good lines. So first you mention this line, the cast needs to be removed after about 6 weeks, and after that child can resume light activities such as swimming and this, followed by vigorous activities after 3 to 6 months. So that is how you compile the whole line. I will show you how to write it, because this is a special line that is where English counts in. So I will tell you how to write so that you can actually see and can write it nicely. So I'm writing it over here. So I will say Master Sammy it further. So I will start with this further. It is important to be noted. That is how you write. It is important to be noted that Master Sammy, M bada, Sammy, S capital. Master Sammy, these are small things which are very important. Master Sammy can resume, needs to be removed after 6 weeks, and then Master Sammy can resume ka matlab dobara le sakta hai, can resume light activities. So to 6 weeks ke baad wo light activities kar payega, light activities. Then you say followed by, that is what I want to teach afterwards, ki uske baad, followed by vigorous ka matlab tez activities, jo bhi jyada, jisme jyada energy chahiye, followed by the vigorous activities after 3 to 6 months. So that is how you use it. So then, because I have, what I have done is like I have written 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 words. If I say 7 words in this, if I say 7 words in this, and maybe 6 words in this, and so 6 plus 7 13 plus 7 20 plus almost 9 or 10 is 30 words. So I have written this big information when I know my letter is going to go high. So I have written all this information in 30 words only. So that is why all this information. So that is how I save my data. It is very important to save your words so that you can be known. So if no complication, if you do not understand the advice provided, please speak to it. This is not important. Ya fir aise keh sakte ho, feel free to, ye this line would be covered. Should you require further information, feel free to contact us, or feel free to contact the nurse or the doctors. If the child suffers from lot of pain at home that does not get better with the painkillers, please contact the doctor. So you can say please note, or you can say it is also important to call a doctor. To contact the doctor in case if pain does not subside. That is the point. Yeah. So in case if the pain does not subside, you can contact the doctor. So that is how you make it special, like writing the way the pain does not subside. So in case if the pain does not subside, it is important to contact the doctor. So very simple letter, a very simple one that you have to write it to parents. So parents would be very simple. I'm writing this letter regarding your son, Master Sammy, who was admitted to our hospital with distal radius fracture. After treatment, his condition is better, so he's being discharged and at home. However, at home, you are advised to follow few instructions for a speedy recovery. Then it would be followed by Master Sammy can feel sore for few days, so it is important to provide him paracetamol, but it is important to make sure that he should not become addicted to the medications. Also, in the first 2-3 days, it can be given regularly. Then apart from this, plaster cast must be taken care of. It should not get wet. And in case of showering, please use plastic bag, but it can, again, if it becomes wet, in that case, use dry hair at cool setting. And then apart from this, whatever the points were. So it's very simple. That is how you will write. You can make 3 paragraphs. You can make 4 paragraphs, 5 paragraphs, according to your convenience. And there is nothing to worry. And just write the simplest of the letter. Just try to save words. Do not make like 220 or 30 words. Please try to count your words. Do not make it more than 200 words. Please. It's around 195 to 200 words. Maximum 205. So we are working in the range of 195 to 205. So please do not take more than it. OET says 180 to 200. My personal experience is 195 to 205. Please do not make any other word. Don't make it to 20 to 30. Please do not. You have to. That is what you need to learn in OET. There is no other job. Data has been given. Everything has been provided to you. So you need to use the right connectors. Again, I told you about the marking scheme. That when your grammar is good, only when your grammar is superb, in OET, you may score 300. When you do the data selection, a good data selection with grammar, you get 350. When you use the right connectors, then you get 400. So you have to add all these things together. And when you use it fluently, when you do it without any effort, as everybody says, that great things are great because of not too much effort. Great things are great because they are achieved effortlessly. Like when a good swimmer swims, he swims effortlessly. When a new swimmer swims, he swims with lot of effort and he does everything except swimming itself. He makes the whole water go crazy, but he is unable to swim. So that is what I say. Write the OET in the simplest of the ways, effortlessly. So neither the reader, so that means your examiner, nor yourself should have any kind of problems. So fluency is very important. Fluency will come when you will use the right connector. Suppose that line I talk about, in case. So like this line is example. The cast must be kept dry and a plastic, that is how you write, a plastic bag should be encouraged. That is how you can make it good. Should be encouraged while showering. That is how you say. However, if at all it gets wet, agar wo wet ho jata hai, then in that case, that is how you write fluently. Then in that case, a dry hair dryer at cool setting may be helpful. So that is the point. That is how it will go. So this is the perfect way of writing. That is what I am talking about. Effortless, or I would say fluency of writing. The cast must be kept dry, comma, and a plastic bag should be encouraged while showering. However, if at all it gets wet, then in that case, hair dryer at the cool setting may be helpful. So that is how you write. This is fluency, and this is what gives you 450, 400. OET does not demand anything for A. It is so simple to get A. And again, the same rule. I am just going to unmute you. आपको मुझे वो rule बताने मैंने आपको क्या rule बताया हुआ है? बस वो last rule करके then I am stopping the recording. So मुझे कौन बताएगा वो rule क्या है? कि मुश्किल है तो क्या करना है?
छोड़ दो
बड़ा है तो
तोड़ दो
so that your fluency can be maintained. If there is any line that is difficult, please leave it. Do not consider in your letter if it is not important, especially then. If you are doubtful about that line, if you are doubtful that whether it is important to be mentioned in the data, but if it is doubtful as well as difficult, please leave it. Leave it immediately. Don't think about that line to write in the exam. These are the negative things which kind of distract you, which kinds of, you know, kind of catches your attention in the exam. So please leave it, leave it, leave it. And for the rest of the things, apart from this, if it is a very big sentence, please break it and use a connector. Suppose it says about this and this and this, simply say, like I said, the cask must be kept dry and water should be, and plastic bag should be encouraged while showering. I broke it, then I said full stop. In case if it gets wet, however, then I use the connector, however. However, in case if it gets wet, agar wo phir bhi gilla ho jata hai toh plaster, then hair dryer se aap use cool setting pe dry kar lena. So that is how simple it is. And that is what makes OET such an easy test to pass, especially in the writing, especially when you want to come to UK and you want to score only 300. There is no point to miss it out unless you do something from yourself. Again, first of all, word count can be one of the problem. So again, listen to this recording 3 times. Then you will realize word count can be a problem. So try to make good connectors. Otherwise, you can leave the lines which are doubtful, which are kind of dicey data. Then second thing, do not consider any difficult line. Third thing, always note in the, always start the letter from the back. Always note to whom we are writing the letter. This is the most important thing. To whom we are writing the letter is the first thing that you say, you see, and then the purpose of the letter. That why are you writing the letter? So in this case, the first point I saw was I was writing the letter to the parents. And the second point I could realize that I have to mention it, that the purpose is that your child was admitted with distal fracture. Now he is better. So he's being discharged at home. But at home, you are advised to follow a few instructions for his speedy recovery. So you can give the parents advice. So that is how the whole letter will go. So I'm switching off the recording. And of course, I will take your questions as usual. So I'm just going to mute. I have already unmuted you all. So this is Dr. Bhupesh from Dr. BKM Institute, stopping the recording. And then now I am ready to take your questions. Please ask as much as you can. Thank you.